don't I know you, sir?
Don't believe so. I haven't been here in many years. Name's Silas Greaves.
Silas Greaves? The bounty hunter?
Used to be.
What are you doing here in Abilene?
Just passing through. Got a little business to take care of.
Well, sir, it would be an honor if you would allow me to buy you a beer.
Hell, son, it would be my honor to drink it.
I'm Molly. Howdy.
I'm Dwight. That's Jack and Steve. Ben's behind the bar. Oh, I bet you got some great stories.
A couple.
Any of them true?
Jack, be nice.
A few.
What about your shootout with Henry Plummer's gang in Bannock, Montana? Is that where you started as a bounty hunter? That's what it says in this here dime novel.
Don't believe everything you read in them dime novels, boy. First man I hunted was back when I was riding with Billy the Kid.
You knew Billy the Kid?
Damn right. That scrawny son of a bitch had no fear. Wouldn't back down for nobody.
I heard he collected the tin stars off any crooked lawman who crossed him.
It was a war, boy. The Lincoln County War. And Billy promised his regulators would take the life of every bastard who helped bushwhack John Tunstall.
Kid had a big chip on his shoulder and a hair-trigger temper. Made him dangerous as hell. It was about 30 years ago. Billy was hiding out in an abandoned farm near Stinking Springs. I threw in with the kid because the man I had sworn vengeance on was riding with Billy's enemies. But before I tell you why I want that sumbitch dead, let me tell you what happened that day. I was heading back to the hideout when suddenly I had this funny feeling.
Funny, haha?
No, Steve. The other kind of funny. I knew those two morons would never let me through. I had no choice.
Who's that?
Is he with us?
Was it Pat Garrett's posse?
Oh, yeah. I heard the shots and I knew I had to move fast. Garrett and his army of deputies had surrounded the entire homestead.
Fire at will! Spread out, goddammit!
They're coming from the rear!
I decided to help Billy and the boys out a bit. So that's just what I did. New Mexico was paying for the kid's apprehension. Garrett was able to hire every gun hand in Lincoln County. I knew that going through that front door meant putting my butt in a shooting gallery, so I decided to get sneaky.
You're dead!
chickens with their heads cut off. Still, one of them reached the water tower. Not a bad idea. It would be a turkey shoot from up there. Luckily, these shooters Garrett hired weren't the sharpest tools in the shed.
I'm here.
A lot of them were saddle tramps or sod busters or drunken drifters looking to make a few bucks. I heard a friendly voice yelling at me from the window.
Back door!
We'll cover you!
Try aiming! Watch your flank!
Truth be told, things weren't much better behind the house. I don't care numbers in half, but that just made the ones that were left twice as mad. For their lack of skill with a seemingly endless supply of ammo. It was a bit of a slog, but I finally fought my way around the back of the house. And like that, I was inside, none the worse for wear. I passed Dirty Dave.
Deader than a rat in a trap!
And upstairs, I found Billy and Charlie Boldry.
How about that? Huh? You like that?
Billy looked at me and said, "About time, amigo! Grab a gun and get to the window!"
Wait, so you were friends with Billy the Kid?
Yeah, sort of. Anyway, we were surrounded by dozens of deputized shooters who wanted to do us harm.
Where the hell did Garrett get to?
knew Garrick's men were dropping like flies, but they just kept on coming. That's when Charlie got hit. "They're catching us in a crossfire," shouted Billy. "Get to the other side." Suckers I personally put down, but it was pretty clear, even to Billy, that maybe discretion was the better part of valor.
Simon.
It means that it was time to cut and run.
"They got a Gatling," Billy shouted. "Get the horses and bring them around back. I'll draw their attention."
It was time to cut and run. He directed that order at me, and I thought, why the hell do I have to do it? But I went anyway. Dumbass that I was. Many would have fled in my place. But I had that false sense of invincibility that many young men have, like Jack here.
What are you saying, old man?
Jack, he's just joshing with you.
Yeah, he better be.
Mr. Graves, please continue.
Please, call me Silas, ma'am. Now, where was I?
We're heading for the barn.
Gonna gut you like a fish!
Making my way past the passing of the foes.
Sounds like Garrett hired a whole regiment of hired guns.
Yeah, and just when I thought I was done with them, more of these hapless bastards will pop up. Finally. I had the stables within my reach. And that that's when I met Sheriff Pat Garrett.
I read that you went toe-to-toe with him, sir. That backstabbing bastard with that tacked-on tin star. Challenged him to a showdown.
You read that in a dime novel?
It said he showed no fear as he took your measure with eyes like a rattlesnake. Killed him in a fair fight.
Is that what that Penny Dreadful said? No, boy. That ain't what I meant when I said I met Pat Garrett. So let me start again. I finally reached those damn stables. Stepped inside, and bam! Last thing I heard was Garrett's voice. That's not Billy.
And go on, how did it end?
End? Boy, that was just the beginning.
So what happened? Did Garrett arrest you?
Yeah, after I came to. Bastard had clocked me with his Colt.
And the kid surrendered?
When he realized there was no getting out of there alive.
So they locked you up in Lincoln?
Indeed they did. Sentenced me to hang right along with the kid. It's important to know that I was only riding with Billy so I could find the bastard I was after. He was with John Kinney's gang, and they were sworn enemies of Billy's regulators.
Why were you after him?
I owed that son of a bitch a bullet for what he had done to me and mine. Instead, all I got for myself was a goddamn death sentence. Luckily, it was right around then that I heard Billy make his move. He shot Jim Bell and a few other guards as he made his getaway. Later, they wrote that some lady friend planted a pistol for him in the privy. What the papers didn't say is that Billy helped me escape, too. My first order of business was finding a firearm.